Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Well, it's that time of year when you need to put away your toys. But to do that properly, you need to go through what they call a winterization process. And that's what I'm going to show you on our 2009 Mercury 200XL Verado. But before we get started, let's head over to the table and look at the tools and the parts we're going to need to pull this off. These are all the products that you're going to need to safely and effectively winterize your outboard for the off season. Now there's a couple of different processes we're going to be going through. We're going to change the lower unit oil. We have a video that shows you how to do that, so if you would reference it, and I can walk you through that process. The other oil that we have to deal with is the engine oil. We also have a video for that, so reference that video and I can walk you through it as well. Now to that, in this video, we're going to show you how to apply the fogging oil, the fuel stabilizer, and then corrosion guard. Now, as far as the tools, well, it's going to be just basic hand tools, and I'll call out whatever size that I'm using so you can find it in your box. Well, now that we've got our products and our tools organized and ready to roll, let's step over there and get this little project done. So the first thing we need to do is actually part of your regular maintenance schedule. You want to go ahead and change the fluid in the lower unit, and once that's done, go ahead and change the oil and the filter in the power head. Now, if you need detailed instructions, we actually have videos on this particular unit where I can walk you through the process. All right, next, we need to address the fuel system. And to do that, we want to bring in some fuel stabilizer. What you'll need to do is just add this to the fuel tank, crank up the engine, give it enough time to actually draw some of that fluid in and circulate it through the fuel system of the engine itself. Now, I can't do that at the moment because, well, we're just sitting on an engine stand. But simple to do, just follow whatever guidelines they give you on the fuel stabilizer itself so you don't oversaturate the system or, worse yet, not get enough in there. So whichever one you go with, read the instructions and just follow it accordingly. Next, we want to address the combustion chamber of the engine itself. And the best way to access that is to pull the spark plugs and actually spray in a fogging oil. So that's what we're going to do next. So let's get our harness pulled off of each coil. And then you just got an 8mm that holds the coil in to the head. I know this is a little bit time consuming, but it'll pay off in the long run if you do this each and every year. As you go through this process, you're almost guaranteed, as long as you have a good battery, that your engine is going to start back up when you need it. The top two are really easy to deal with. The second, we have to get rid of part of the cowling to get to it. And there is a 8mm bolt on the latch that we need to remove the pivot point. And then that'll expose two more bolts going into this section. There we go. All right, someone has already removed these two screws. So what we want to do is hit a couple of pry points and then remove this cover. There we go. Making progress. Now we just need to pull these four 8mm, and that's going to allow this locking plate to come out, and that'll give us access to those last two coils. There we go. There, there. That was just in hand tight. I get the feeling somebody's been in here before. What do y'all think? Figured out what it was and then ran away. Well, we've never experienced that, have we? Hopefully the plugs you pull out of your engine look a lot better than this. Not looking too spiffy either. This is what will happen to your engine on the inside if you set it up without spraying it with fogging oil and then let it sit for a long period of time. It'll actually rust the inside. No, number two didn't look that bad, but three and four look terrible. Yep. What we need to do now is just spray a couple of seconds worth of this fogging oil directly into the chamber. Now you don't want to get carried away here because when you go to start it, I mean, granted, it's going to dissipate after a while, but we don't want to pump so much in there that we hydrolock our engine from too much fogging oil. So we'll start up top. 1, 2, 3. That should be enough. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right. Now, let's just get our plugs back in and get our coils back on. All right, let's take these to 20 foot-pounds. And get our coils back in. All right, the last step in this process is to give it a nice coat of corrosion guard. Now, you can use this anywhere on the engine except for any area where the belts are and or the anodes. You want to keep it away from those. Now, obviously, we still have a lot more work to do on our engine, so I'm going to put that to the side for right now. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments? Leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.